What's up, guys? Super Mesh here. Welcome to another pack opening. Chaotic. Can't say that damn word. Chaotic compliance pack opening. So I've been looking at the list of the set, and we've got some Gemini support, you know what, let me just go in the shop and stop pretending that I know what I'm talking about. So we're gonna look at all right, Gemini support, psychic support, damn, tip of my tongue, bro. And Morphine support. Okay, so last pack opening, kind of pull a couple of supers. If we'll look here, I got Destructotron. That's like, what was that? Was that Ninja Turtles? Damn, I forgot. You know that villain who has Krang in his belly? I forgot the villain's name, but whatever. He's ugly as fuck. So I pulled this guy. I pulled the Fusion Substitute, which I needed. And a couple of these cards here. Psychics. I pulled Big Koala, the Big Papa Bear. I got a Jar of Avarice. Anyway, I'm going to stop talking. Alright, because I just want to go ahead and open some damn packs. Let's do this. Oops. What? Cheers. Do I want to do? I want to keep this short and sweet. So let's do 10 packs. Right away. Right away, 10 packs. Actually, you know what? I'm going to stick to one pack. One pack. I'm not going to do 10 packs because I just don't. Alright, let's do one pack. Please give me new cards. Black Luster Ritual, so I can finally summon that badass card, ritual card. And this card is used to ritual summon Black Luster Soldier. You must also tribute monsters from your hand, field whose total levels are 8 or more. New card, Domino Effect. When a monster your opponent controls is destroyed by battle and sent to the graveyard, you can send one monster you control to the graveyard and destroy one monster your opponent controls. Yeah, destroy. Domino effect. Destroy yours, destroy your opponents, destroy your monster, and destroy your opponents. I'm not sure how that will be useful. It might be. I don't know. For me, I can't find any use for that just yet. Oh, what? I just saw this card on Facebook. And one guy was asking, he's like, why is this card even on this game? It just looks so real. Look at that. Oh, wow. When this card is sent to your graveyard, add it to your deck and shuffle it. Stacking? Can you stack in Duel Links? Maybe if it was in real life, like, if you're a stacker, like, you know what? Let me put dog in the deck and... Right? I don't know. But it's a cute card. No complaints, really. I just don't have use for it. Is all I'm saying. Next pack. Or second pack. We got 3 Kuribos. Are we getting some light show? Nope, we're not. Seismic Crasher. Twice per turn, you can send one phase-up continuous spell card or trap card, continuous trap card you control to the graveyard to inflict 500 damage to your opponent. This could be useful. Stray Asmodian. When this card is destroyed and sent to the graveyard by battle, both players gain 800 life points. Anything that gives you life points is absolutely amazing. 800 life points. Telekinetic Shocker. That's probably my second one. Third pack. Glossy. Maybe. Shiny. It shines. Yep. I can say that. Seismic Crasher, Malice Dispersion, and Lekunga. I remember this card. You can banish two water monsters. So again, for Mako users. Monsters from your graveyard. Special summon one Lekunga token. And in attack position. So you can probably use this with that continuous spell card that summons slime token. I forgot what it's called, but you could probably combo it with this and summon Daedalus. Right? I don't know. Maybe. I don't know what I'm talking about. Fourth pack. Come on. We've got some hieroglyphics of some sort in the background. We've got Stormcaller and Psychic. You can put... Oh, man, that text is so tiny. That's what she said. You can put your opponent's monsters that are destroyed by battle with other Psychic-type monsters on top of their owner's deck instead of sending them to the graveyard. When this card is destroyed by card effect, this card's control takes damage equal to its original attack. So let's say your opponent has one card left, and it's a psychic, right? So you can put your opponent's monsters that are destroyed by battle with other psychic-type monsters on top of their owner's deck. So if they have one card on the field, you keep attacking it. Keep putting it on top of their decks. So, and I don't know, maybe I might be understanding this wrong, but each time you, it's like the only card that comes to mind in real life is Ryza. So you put it at the top of your deck. If your opponent has one card, kind of just kept attacking, and they keep drawing the same ass card, and until you attack for game. If I understand that correctly. If not, let me know down in the comments below. Roast me. If you need to. Gather your mind. Add one. Gather your mind from your deck to your hand. Your deck is then shuffled. You can only use one gather your mind. Again, deck thinning. You want to thin your deck. You use this card. Baby Saurus. So Sarasaurus. Baby Sarasaurus. I'll be right back. I need a drink.
My cat, by the way.
Alright, we're back. Cheers. That's enough distraction. Let's open some more packs. Alright. How many packs do we have left? This is our fifth pack. No SRs yet. No URs. Ultras and Supers. Come on. Poison Fangs. Each time a beast-type monster inflicts battle damage to your opponent, inflict 500 damage to your life points. To their life points. Maju Garzet. Dark Fiend. The attack of this card becomes equal to the combined original attack of the two monsters you attributed for the tribute summoned of this card. Ooh. Damn. Imagine if you had two blue eyes on board and you tribute summon this boss card right here. You got like, what, 7,000? But you don't need to. So since the attack is question mark, you can't really activate that spell card. that can make your opponent's that can make your card attack your opponent's life points directly. So you can't use that because it's a question mark. You don't really know that it's zero. All right, that's fine. Two new cards. All right. This is the sixth pack out of 10. Come on, let me pull some SRs. At least some SRs. Herculean Power. Once per turn, if your opponent controls a monster and you control no monsters, you can special summon one level 4. Oh, okay. Alright. That's a good support for Geminis. So you can special summon it, and then once it's on the field, you can double summon it. Well, not double summon. I don't mean the card double summon. You can summon it to gain its effects. Good card. Damn, nothing yet, huh? So, seventh pack. Let me see some ultras. Let me see some supers. Super War Lion and Genetic Woman. Dude, 8th pack and nothing yet. No, this is, yeah, it's 8. Number 8. Lucky number 8, 3 Kuribos, glowing pack. This better be a freaking ultra or else. Oh, a face. Tokusho of Ghost Destroying. What? It's a monster? Is it an ultra? Are we going to see ultra? Oh! Screech! Son of a gun. It's a reptile, water. It's good for water decks. This card is drawn by battle. Send two water monsters from your deck to the graveyard. But what are you going to send? Like what? Maybe if Atlanteans was... This could be good. I just don't know what other monsters that you can send to the graveyard that has an effect when it's sent there. From your deck. So the only cards I could think of is Atlanteans, which is not here yet. Which is not in the game. It's a super. Could be useful. I don't know. Ninth. Second last pack, folks. Yes. 3 Kuribos. We got Psychic Path, pay 800 life points and select up to 2 of your remove from play Psychic type monsters. Add them to your hand. You got Space Time Police. When this card is bad, target one face. Up card your point control. Banish that target when this card leaves the field. Set that card. Set the card that was banished by this effect to your opponent's side of the field. Weed out. Pay 5 of the life points. Destroy all phase of attack monsters. Position level 3 monsters. So, Mystic Shine Ball. Is that Injection Fairy Lily? I don't think so. That's Gyakuri Panda. And what's the other guy? I don't know what that card is. Come on, one more SR, folks. One pack left. Let's end with something good, please. 3 Kuribos. No glowing. Weapon change, Javelin Beetle, and Weed Out. Oh, lordy. That is it. You know what? I might just get 30 packs. 30 packs. Should I do it? I think I should. Should I do it? I support this game. I've been supporting this game since 1999. So I'm going to get 30 packs. All right. It's giving back to the game. 30 packs, folks. Right away, we get a super. What did I tell you about using real money? You get more good shit. Huh? Death's Kangaroo. The attack of a monster that attacks this monster is lower. If the attack of a monster that attacks this monster is lower than the defense of this card. So let's say your opponent has a 1600 attack. A monster, if it attacks this card, destroy that attacking monster. Damage calculation is applied normally. So, but still, your monster gets destroyed. But it's kind of like a Yomi ship, but you still take damage. Right? That's fine. Got Stormcaller. Got Machine King, 3000 BC. Holy text, that's tiny. I can't read it. Special summon this card as an effect monster, so sort of like embodiment of Apophis. Apophis. This card is also still a trap card, so you can Twister it, you can Storm it, you can Grave Sandstorm it, or whatever. You cannot normal or special summon other monsters. Once per turn, where am I? Once per turn during your main phase, you can tribute one machine type monster. Okay, so it's for machines. This card gains attack equal to the attack of the tributed monster had on the field. Attack the tributed monster until the end of this turn. So good support for machine kings and all that stuff. What's next? Herculean power, and that's it. Next pack. Another glowing pack, folks. Bam! Molten Zombie. When this card is special summoned from the graveyard, draw one card. It's a pyro. If this was an actual zombie with Book of Life, and if Cards of Safe Return is here, I'm sure it's going to... Well, it's going to break the game if Cards of Safe Return comes to this game. It's going to be... Skelesaurus. It's too tiny. My eyes hurt just looking at that text, so I'm not going to read it. Just Google it. And a Gemini booster. Pretty awesome card. Equip this card to a Gemini monster you control. A Gemini support card is an equip card. It gains 700 attack when this card destroys while equipped. And send to the graveyard, select one face-up Gemini monster, and treat it as an effect monster. Pretty awesome. I might just build this deck. I might just build a Gemini deck. Another one? Okay. Super War Lion and Ducker Mobile. It is raining supers. I still have yet to pull an Ultra, so this could be it. Still an SR, Darkstorm Dragon, it's a dragon, and it's a Gemini. Wow. Once per turn, so this is the effect when it's double summoned. So you can use double summon, but it's level, is this level 9 or 8? I think it's level 8, so how? It's hard to summon. Maybe you can use that trap card. Once per turn, you can send one face-up spell trap card you control to the graveyard. Destroy all spell trap cards on the field. Holy. Looks like, to me, that looks like an Infernoid card. Next, to be lost, Sanguini? Sanguine? If you control any other spell or trap card, destroy this card. Face down spell trap cards cannot be activated. Destroy this card during your end phase. So it's kind of like Sing Zen Who? Who? Sing Zen. If you control any other spell or trap cards, destroy it. Face down spell and trap cards cannot be activated. So it counts. it also counts your spell trap cards. So if you have this activated, you can't activate any. Yeah, but if you control any other spell trap cards, you can. So it's a good side deck for trap heavy decks. Especially burn decks. You can side this against a burn deck. Activate this. They won't be able to activate attack and receive or whatever that is that they set. Earth Chant, not bad. Another glowing pack. Malice Dispersion. Ghost Fairy Elphobia. I think I have this card. It's a super rare in real life. Once per turn, you can reveal one wind monster in your hand until the end of your opponent's next main phase 1. Monsters with a level higher than the revealed monster cannot activate their effects. How is that useful right now? I don't know. I can't think of anything. Monster Incarnation. Hallelujah. Thought it was a monster reborn for a second there. Which I know it's not going to come into this game, but who knows? Anything can happen. Anything can happen. That's good. I think we are on our 10th pack here. Master Kyonshi, awesome card. Skelosaurus. Come on, let's give me some new cards. Another Swamp, which is awesome. ESP Amplifier. All phase up psychic type monsters you controlled when this card was activated gains 300 attack for each of your psychic monsters. It's a quick play. It's removed from play when this card resolves. During the end phase, remove from play all monsters that were affected by this effect. Ooh. It's kind of like Super Poly. What's that card? Not Metal Morph. Limiter Removal. Sort of something like to a, well, not similar effect, but it kind of has the same effect. I don't know what to say, but it's a quick play. So all phase up psychic, limiter is for machines. So you double up their attack, but this one only gives you 300 attack for each psychic type monster that is removed from play when this card resolves. So if you have removed from play, kind of. Still, but during the end phase, remove from play all monsters that were affected by this effect. So any psychic monsters that you have on board will be removed from play. So you better go for game if you activate this card, is all I'm saying. Spell Absorption. Each time a spell card is activated, gain 500 life points immediately after it resolves. Okay. I'm good with that. Option Hunter and Genetic Woman. Oop. Some little birds in the background. Plant Pathfinder. You can tribute this card. Add one field spell card from your deck to your hand. Puppet King. When your opponent adds a monster from their when your opponent adds a monster card to their hand except by drawing, you can special summon this card from. So, what was that card again? It is used to get Black Luster Soldier. I was actually in Loner Deck Duels earlier. So I saw this card used against me. I activated that spell card to get Black BLS. Yeah, BLS from my deck. And this guy was special summoned, but it got destroyed during the end phase. But it's a big-ass attack card, so chances are you won't be able to attack your opponent unless you have Econ, Tribute Summon, get discard, and attack your opponent for game. Alright. Black Luster Ritual. Sasuke Samurai Lekunga. That card, man. That card gives me the creeps. Yes. Hard Selling Zombie. Sky Star Ray. Sky Star. What stuff? This card can attack your opponent directly. At the end of the battle phase, if this card attacked directly, banish this card until your next standby phase. Huh. This could be an annoying card. could be a really annoying card. It's a wind. So if you want to use it in your Harpy deck, go ahead. So it can attack your opponent directly. At the end of the battle phase, if it attacked directly, you can use... Again, I keep forgetting that card. What is that card? God damn it. Yeah, you use it with... You use it on Piranha. That when you farm... temple? Crap. I don't know. I forgot. So, yeah, you can use it on this. Attack directly. You remove it. And then your next time it phase comes back. It's just... You can also use it as a tribute fodder for other level 5 and Dragonic Knight. A really good side deck card. Don't sleep on that Dragonic Knight, because you're going to see that. You're going to see it. Sanguine. What are you talking about? I already have this card. Why is this new? I pulled this card. Right? Chitonian Alliance. Equip monster gains 800 attack for each other face-up monsters on the field that has the same name. Chitonian. What? Gains 800 attack for each other face-up monsters on the field that has the same name it does. I read it the third time. I still don't understand the effect. Maybe I'm just an idiot. I'll have to read that later. Pass. Cardbreaker. So, this card is normal, cannot be normal summoned or set. This card can only be specialed in face-up attack by sending one card from your spell and trap card zone to the graveyard. So it didn't say face-up spell or trap card, it said spell or trap. No face-up, no face-down. So any, if it's face-up, you can send balloons, you can send mirror wall. By sending one card, this card can be... Okay. It's 100 attack, though. How's that? It's a warrior. It cannot be normal set. This card can only be special summoned in face-up attack position by sending one card from special summon. How is this useful? Could be useful. I don't know. Pass? Alright. Three Kuribos. Stormcaller, Javelin Beetle Pack. It's a new card, so I gotta read this. This card can be used for the Javelin Beetle. You can also... I haven't pulled any BLS yet. What the hell? You must also tribute monsters from the field or your hand whose total level is equal to 8 or more. Okay. Zeta Reticulans. Eva Token. Each time a monster your opponent controls is removed from play, special summon one Eva Token. Fiend, level 2, 500 attack, 500 defense. It's a big-ass level monster. Alright, are you going to pull a super? Poison Fangs, Disturbance Strategy. Your opponent shovels their entire hand into the deck, then draws the same number of cards. A mulligan? But we already have a skill. Like a restart skill. A restart that my or... Odeon uses. I don't know, but why would I use this? Seal of Wickedness. Once per turn during your opponent's standby phase, select one face-up card on the field. The selected card effects is negated during that turn. During each of your standby phases, pay 500 life points. So once per turn during your opponent's standby phase, one face-up card on the field, the selected card's effect is negated during that turn. So it only negates monsters effects that are on the field. But let's say you have Goblin Zombie or Gravekeeper's Recruiter. If they go to the graveyard, their effects will still activate. So but this could be good against it's sort of like pulling the rug when, let's say, your opponent's using Gravekeepers and tribute summons for Oracle or Chief. You flip this card and they won't be able to activate their effect. If I'm not mistaken. But I'm sure you can. That's how you can use this against that deck. So once per turn during your opponent's standby phase, select one face-up card on the field. The selected card's effects is negated during that turn. Yeah, so that's pretty good. It's a good side deck against Oracle and Chief. I'm going to use that card. Oh, we got an Exploded Karibo, a Yellow Glowing, and a Face, a Weapon Change, an ESP Amplifier, and another Fusion Substitute. That's my second one. What? Alright, that's fine. That's fine. That is good. That is good. Machine King and a Minefield Driller? When this face-up card you control leaves the field and is still in your possession, you can target one field spell card in your graveyard. Add that target to your hand. I don't use field spell cards, so that's of no use to me. Another Strasmodian. Gain 800 and Seismic Shockwave. This is good for dinosaurs, I think. Yeah, dinosaur type. It's a good one. Destroy this card during your third standby phase after activation. Activate this card when a face-up dinosaur type monster you control is destroyed and sent to the graveyard. So destroyed. Not by battle. And not tributed as well. Only destroyed. So, I mean, destroyed by battle counts as well. Sent to the graveyard during the damage step. Choose three of your opponent's unused spell and trap card zones. Those zones cannot be used. Wow. Okay. It's just a card that can annoy your opponent. I would use it. Add that target to your hand. I don't know. It's a lot of text there. Come on, BLS. Array of Revealing Light. Let's digraph right there. That's for sure. Declare one type of it's a field card. Declare one type of monster. Cannot declare an attack during the turn. It's normal summon, flip summon, or special. Okay. That'll probably be a good farming card against a theme deck. Dr. Cranium, Psychic. When this card is destroyed by battle and sent to the graveyard, you can pay 800 life points to add one psychic type. What? Why do I gotta pay 800 life points? I don't want that. Generation Shift. Target one face-up monster you control, destroy that target. Then add one card with the same name as the destroyed card from your deck to your hand. And then we got the Garzette. Right. Second booster next to be lost. And a Herculean. But why was it glowing? Alright. Three Karibos. Glowing a face. Sasuke Samurai 3. Oh, I should have read that card. Weapon change. This card. Gateway to Chaos. Alright. So that's a super rare. That's not bad. But I want a UR. So you can add, I actually have this card in real life, which I use for the same purpose to get BLS from the deck to your hand. Alright, that's cool. No, not BLS. But you add a ritual spell card from your deck to your hand, yeah. Generation Ship, second booster, and that's this card. Alright. I think we're on our 20-something pack. Luster Dragon number 2. Alright. Come on. Give me a UR, Trojan Blast, Maju Garzette. Poison Fangs, Weed Out. Prometheus, King of the Shadows. If this card is normal summon, banish any number of dark monsters from your graveyard. And if you do, This card gains 400 attack for each. It's good for Fiend. Prepare to strike back. Each time your opponent declares a face-up defense position monster as an attack target, toss a coin and call it. If you call it right, change the target to attack. If you call it wrong, the controller of this card takes damage equal to the amount. I don't want to use that card. And that is it. So we pulled how many SRs here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 SRs. No URs. Wow. They're really making it hard to pull URs in this. Or maybe it's just me. I don't know. Alright guys, I'm going to end it with 6 SRs. I hope you like this video. Don't forget to hammer that like button down below. Don't forget to leave your comments down in the comment section below. And please share this video. And if this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe for more pack openings, Yu-Gi-Oh! Online, and all that shit. And again, as always, keep it mint. Peace. Oh, wait a second. I still have 300 gems from that purchase. So we're going to continue. I still have some packs. So excited. I thought I was done, but since I got that 39 something, I got me some 300 gems on top of it. So I'm just going to do a six pack. Ooh. I'm not gonna do one by one. Make this real quick. Oh, yes, the second one.
Uh-huh.
Give it to me, baby. Nice. More psychic. What is going on? Another one. Hell yeah. Alright, so those three, two supers and ultras, is pretty good. Face? A rare, okay. War Lion, Option Hunter, and Genetic Woman. That's it! And this is it, folks. This is the end. Two supers and an ultra, six packs. That was the best six packs I've opened after that purchase. Unbelievable. Again, guys, thank you for watching. As always, keep it mint. Peace.